Good morning students, happy new year. Hope you all are doing fine. Welcome back to social studies class. Today we will study the new chapter, chapter 17, winning freedom. Let us see the introduction part. India's struggle for independence was unique in many ways. First, it tested the ways of non-violence or ahimsa to protect against the injustice of the ruling colonial power and became successful. Second, it shows that bloodshed is always not necessary for sowing one's discontent. Third, it held that peaceful non-cooperation was the right of the people for wrong policies of the government. Now, let us study the course of the freedom struggle after the Great Revolt of 57. The Indian National Congress. It was an organization formed in 1885 by a retired British bureaucrat named A.O. Quinn. The main purpose for the formation of the Indian National Congress at that time was to give the educated Indians a platform to have a civic and political dialogue with the British government. The first session of the Indian National Congress took place in Bombay and was attended by 72 delegates. In the beginning, the members of the Congress were moderates who believed in requesting the government for reforms. Later on, another group of radicals developed in the Congress who believed in fighting for their demands to the British. Partition of Bengal. Lord Curzon played the trump card of divide and rule policy to break the national unity among the majority of Indian population on religious grounds. Bengal, which consisted of Hindus and Muslims, was partitioned in 1905. The British partitioned Bengal in the name of administrative convenience, but their main motive was to divide the Hindu-Muslim unity and divert the attention of people from nationalism and protect against the government. Sudesi and boycott movements. The Sudesi and boycott movements aimed to sensitize people towards using the goods and services of their own country and boycotting all the foreign goods and services. Vande Mataram, presently the national song of India, was composed in 1882 and translated into English in 1909. The Rowlatt Act. This act was termed as a Black Act, as it authorized the government to arrest anyone suspicious of working against the government. All the top-ranking leaders were arrested on the ground of causing public unrest. On 13th April 1919, a peaceful public gathering was held in the Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar to protest against the unlawful policies of the government. A British officer named General Tyre came with his troops, blocked the only gate of the park and opened fire on the innocent public without warning. The firing only stopped when all the ammunition was over. As per the official records, 379 people were killed and 1,137 wounded in this incident. This incident sparked a fresh row of protests against the government and gave birth to another great movement. The movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi to protest against the Jallianwala Bagh massacre and the injustice done by the British government after the First World War by disobeying the government. People from all walks of life participated in this movement by peacefully resisting the government. They boycotted foreign clothes, picked liquor shops, left government schools, colleges and government jobs, and abandoned government factories. The non-cooperation movement was a major setback for the government. Unfortunately, a violent incident in Chauri Chaura took place in 1922, In this incident, villagers agitated by the killing of some people set a police station on fire, in which 22 policemen were killed. Mahatma Gandhi was so upset that he withdrew the movement, thinking that it had deviated from the path of non-violence. This movement started in 1930 when the Congress gave the slogan of Purna Swaraj, meaning complete independence. This movement started with Gandhiji's Dandi March along with his followers from the Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi in Gujarat. Gandhiji made salt to break the salt law. It aimed at completely defying the government by peaceful means like non-payment of taxes and breaking other laws. This movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi in August 1942. It aimed at throwing out the British government from India. Gandhiji gave the slogan of "Do or Die" to the people. Most of the prominent political leaders were jailed during this movement. But it did not die, and the British were compelled to realize that their time in India was over now. Eventually, the government had to agree to hand over the power to the Indians and return home. The British government agreed to free India after the Second World War in 1945. That's all for today's class. Hope you all understood. Thank you. Have a nice day.